Hello friends, most welcome to English Advantage online classes. Friends, in this video I am going to discuss Parajambal tricks for all banking exams. As you know that Parajambal is very important for all banking exams because it is always asked, particularly in bank PO and bank clerk pre-exams. Okay, but most of the students find it extremely difficult to solve. Sometimes Parajambal is very lengthy and very tricky. But I would like to say that if you apply proper logic and proper reasoning, you can solve any Parajambal quite easily. Now let us see this Parajambal. This is the real Parajambal, and this Parajambal was asked in RBI exam, one of the RBI exams. So let us solve this Parajambal. Now as you can see here, five sentences are given here: A, B, C, D and E. Five sentences are given here. Sometimes six or even seven sentences are given in Parajambal, so it makes the Parajambal even more difficult to solve. But let me discuss all the tricks and all the logics that you can apply while solving any Parajambal. Now let me go through all these lines one by one. The policy makers. Now what are the basic guidelines to solve any Parajambal? Okay, so let me discuss these guidelines first. See, in Parajambal, first noun will come and then pronoun will come to replace it. In any sentence, if you spot any pronoun, that is this, that, these, those, such, he, she, it, it means that sentence will come later. That sentence cannot become the first sentence. Okay. For example, you can see here this word, this, importance. So now this is the pronoun. So this sentence cannot become the first sentence. So in any Parajambal, the first thing is that you have to figure out the title sentence, that is the first sentence. And any sentence that is having any kind of pronoun, that is this, that, these, those, such, he, she, it, that sentence cannot become the first sentence because that sentence will replace any previous sentence. Okay, just see here, this importance. Now this is the keyword here. This is the keyword here. It means that this particular sentence is having this pronoun and this sentence cannot become the first sentence. Okay. In the same way, just see here, those programs. Now this is again a pronoun. So this sentence also cannot become the first sentence. Now see here, the socio-economic disparity between rural and urban areas are widening and creating tremendous pressure on social and economic fabric of many such developing countries. Just see this keyword, such developing countries. So what are these developing countries? This word has been used for some developing countries, some developing economies that has been previously used. So this is the reference point, such. Okay. Now again, just see in this sentence, these factors, these is a pronoun. Now this is the real Parajambal I am solving. And basics and principles are always same. The wording will always be different, but the basics and principle will always remain the same. So you have to apply the same principles in any kind of Parajambal. Okay. So we have eliminated all these sentences applying these logics, that these sentences cannot become the first sentence because all these sentences are having any kind of some or other pronoun. For example, this, these, those, such. Okay, so we can infer that this sentence can become the first sentence. Now what does this sentence say? Let me read it out. Although millions of rural people have escaped poverty as a result of rural development in many Asian countries, just see the noun here, Asian countries. Asian countries is the noun. So first noun will come, then pronoun will come to replace it. Okay. So definitely this sentence will become the first sentence. Although millions of rural people have escaped poverty as a result of rural development in many Asian countries, a large majority of rural people continue to suffer from persistent poverty. There has been rural development, and because of rural development, some people have escaped poverty. They have come out of poverty and they have become quite well off. But still, the problem of poverty persists. And large majority of rural people continue to suffer from persistent poverty because there hasn't been adequate amount of rural development in all areas. Okay. Now here we are talking about one fact. This is a fact. Okay. And this sentence C tells the reason of this fact, reason behind this fact. Just see, socio-economic disparity between rural and urban areas are widening and creating tremendous pressure on the social and economic fabric of many such developing countries. So this word such has been used for what? This word such has been used for Asian countries. Okay. So these two sentences are logically connected. Which two sentences? E and C. E and C are logically connected, because here we are talking about a fact and here we are discussing the reason behind this fact. What is the reason? The reason is socio-economic disparities. And socio-economic disparities and widening and creating tremendous pressure on the social and economic fabric of many such developing economies. So these two sentences are logically connected and make a mandatory pair, E and C. Now, in this sentence, we are talking about these factors. These are the factors. Okay, these are the factors. Because of these factors, rural development is not being taken place effectively. Now, here we are talking about these factors. Okay, so after this, we can put this sentence, that is D. Okay, these factors, among many others, tend to highlight the importance of rural development. Now, this importance has been talked about here. Here we are saying this importance. Okay. So here we can put A, and the final sentence that is left with us is B. So this is the combination ECDAB. Okay. That is how we have to solve any kind of parajumble. These are the basic principles to solve any parajumble. And this is the real parajumble. And then on the basis of this this combination ECDAB, you can solve these questions quite easily. Which is the third sentence? Third sentence is D, and D is given in fourth. So here your answer is fourth. Which is the last sentence? Last sentence is B, and B is given in second. Okay. Which of the following should be the fourth sentence? Fourth sentence is A. So here your answer is third. First sentence is E. So here your answer is fifth. And second sentence is C. So here your answer is third. So that is how you have to solve these kind of parajumbles. And if you want to get sure selection in SBI PO and IBPS PO or any other banking or insurance exam, you can join my e-course for complete English section. Okay. The detail of this e-course is given in the description box, and link is also given in the description box. From there, you can join this e-course. So that's it. And if you have found this video class useful, kindly like it, share it with your friend, and do not forget to subscribe if you are the first timer on this channel. So thank you very much for watching this video class, and I'll see you in my next video class. Thank you.